Discussion on the clinical importance of left bundle branch block. Left bundle branch block is usually associated with structural heart disease, unlike right bundle branch block, which may be seen without associated heart disease. LBBB is one cause for paradoxical splitting of second heart sound. Normal split closes in expiration. In paradoxical splitting, split is audible in expiration and closes in inspiration. In normal conduction sequence, left bundle branch block is activated first. Hence, a left bundle branch block can affect the initial vector in the ECG. This leads to errors in interpretation of Q waves in myocardial infarction. Secondary ST segment and T wave abnormalities common with LBBB makes assessment of myocardial ischemia difficult, both at rest and during exercise testing. Various criteria have been proposed for diagnosis of myocardial infarction in the presence of LBBB, of which Scarbosa criteria is most popular. Other criteria described are Sylvester 10% RS criteria and Smith 25% S wave criteria. LBBB has great significance in the setting of left ventricular dysfunction. Dyssynchrony of left ventricular contraction, characteristic of LBBB, can worsen heart failure. That is why cardiac resynchronization therapy aims at reducing the dyssynchrony in those with symptomatic heart failure. Benefits of cardiac resynchronization therapy in heart failure is largely restricted to those with LBBB and QRS width of 150 milliseconds or more, suggesting the role of left ventricular dyssynchrony in heart failure progression. Responders to cardiac resynchronization therapy, which constitutes 2/3 of the patients, exhibit left ventricular reverse remodeling. They also show reduction in QRS width on resynchronization. All-cause mortality was significantly lower in responders. Both His bundle pacing and left bundle branch pacing have been used for correction of dyssynchrony. LBBB correction is a terminology used by some. This results in normal QRS and left ventricular synchronization. His bundle pacing helps by pacing the fibers distant to the left bundle branch within the His bundle. It is known that the fibers segregate before the actual division into left and right bundle branches. LBBB can interfere with echocardiographic interpretation due to the associated abnormalities in left ventricular wall motion. In LBBB, there is a pre-ejection contraction with leftward movement of the septum, followed by immediate rebound stretch and subsequent paradoxical rightward movement. This has also been called as septal flash. Please note that septal flash is different from the respirophasic ventricular septal shift, known as septal bounce, in constrictive pericarditis. Septal flash is early systolic, while septal bounce is early diastolic. LBBB often causes septal perfusion defects in radionuclide myocardial perfusion imaging during exercise test, but this is rare with vasodilator stress. A study comparing 10 patients with LBBB, 10 age-matched controls, and 10 pacemaker patients with right ventricular pacing off and on has been reported. They concluded that the apparent septal perfusion defect in LBBB is mainly due to relative lateral hypoperfusion rather than an absolute decrease in septal flow. Switching pacemaker on during exercise decreased the ratio of septal to lateral wall myocardial blood flow by 17%. Septal perfusion defect is partly due to the heterogeneity in blood flow between left anterior descending and left circumflex coronary arteries due to the delayed septal relaxation. It may be noted that myocardial blood flow is better in diastole when myocardium relaxes, as the systolic contraction reduces blood flow in systole into the intramyocardial vessels. There may be a reduced oxygen demand due to the late septal contraction, which occurs when the wall stress is less.